So first off, I want to say thank you, man, to everybody that clicked this video, everybody who took their time out of their day and, you know, wrote down a question to ask just so they could get to know me better. I want to say thank you, man, before we get started. I'm just going to read out the questions that I haven't answered before. So if I've answered something in my previous Q&A, which you guys can check out, the link is in the description. If you guys haven't seen it, go check it out because I'm not going to be answering questions I have answered before. I'm just looking down the list of, you know, this is pretty much all the comments. Just going to scroll down, see which questions that I haven't answered before and just, you know, answer those questions. I'm not going to go in any specific order, just scrolling down, seeing whatever catches my eye. I thought this is a funny way to start it off, man. Ryan Swindlehurst said, do I have an odd amount of toes? Very odd question to ask. I don't know if you ask people if they have different number of toes. Like, what would it matter? I do have 10 toes, just to answer your question, but so I just had to get that out the way. Liam asked me, what's your favorite sport moment of all time? And my favorite sports play, it's not really a play, but favorite sports moment is definitely in 2006. Miami Heat, when they were in the finals, Dwayne Wade and Shaq, they were down 2-0 to the Dallas Mavericks. And Dwayne Wade went on a complete tear, ended up averaging like 34 points a game for the next four games. And they ended up winning the first championship for Miami. That was my favorite sports moment. If I could, you know, relive it again as a fan, that's probably my favorite sports moment of all time. Apex Vivo asked me, what would you do if you weren't a YouTuber? I just think it's a good question because from a learning perspective too, I just take things for what it is and then move on from that. Like, I can't change the past. Certain things you just don't have control of and you really can't change. So I don't like to think about what I would have been had this not gone right. Because I mean, everything happens for a reason, you know? It's just unrealistic. Don't try to think too much about what things could have been or should be. Focus on where you want it to be. Make sure that's what you strive for and work towards every single day. It doesn't really help anything or anybody if you think of outside, you know, situations, things that really couldn't help. I mean, they don't work for me. That's not how I think. But just from, like, you know, a real life standpoint, that's just not how I operate. I don't think about that. This is what I'm doing. This is what I'm committed to. And that's just how I like to think, man. Another good question, and it was, who got you into sports? I've always been into sports because I've always loved to go outside when I was a kid. Even when I was younger, you know, I used to play soccer a lot. That was like my first sport initially. But I moved to a new neighborhood. In that new neighborhood, it was all about basketball. Like, nobody really played soccer. So I had to adjust, you know, I had to adapt. Obviously, I went to the basketball course every day, you know, ended up meeting, you know, a lot of good friends, people I'm still friends with to this day. And it was because of basketball. So I'm thankful I had a childhood where I could go out, kind of build like camaraderie and be able to go and do something every day because it's fun and now it's play basketball. So it was my environment, I guess, where I came from. That's really what got me into sports pretty much, to answer your question. His name is Press1435. He asked me, one, can I make more basketball videos? And two, more vlogs. I see you've been subscribing for a minute. Thanks to you also. And basically, yeah, man, thanks for asking that question because that's something I've been thinking about. I kind of want to focus more on showing you guys who I am as a person, the things I do. That's when I went to Maryland, I did that Making Moves playlist because I want to start doing more real life things and things that are really gonna let you guys know who I am as a person. Said I'm still gonna do the Madden and the 2K and all that, obviously. You guys really liked the first vlog, so that definitely give me motivation to do more of them. And this way I can take you guys with me wherever I go, show you guys what I get into, kind of activities I like to do and different places I go and things like that, and share it with you guys. So maybe it'll influence you to see it for your own eyes. I will try to do more basketball videos if I do get to work out or something like that, but definitely more vlogs will be coming soon though, that's for sure. Somebody asked, and I don't think I've answered this one before, so I'm gonna answer it now. Brian Phillips asks, why do you like the Miami Heat franchise? That's a very good question. I feel like you should always know why. There's always a backstory to why people will stick to certain teams. And mine basically was just being a fan of Dwayne Wade, you know, coming out of college, the things he did at Marquette. That was really a reason why I was a fan. Got drafted by Miami Heat. That really became the team I watched the most because I wanted to keep up with him. So just off of that, that's really what over the years just made me be a fan. And I was always supporting him, and I still support him to this day. So the Heat is definitely going to be my team from now on because that was really when I started watching basketball too. So Artit Elili asked me, if I could go anywhere in the world, where would I go and why? That's a good question, man. If I could go anywhere in the world, I would go everywhere. I hope, you know, that answers the question. Obviously, you guys probably noticed if you follow me on my Instagram. I went to Brazil 2 years ago for the World Cup. And that's really like my first real experience traveling and going somewhere else for an extended period of time. And it was the best time I ever had in my life. I almost studied abroad in Florence, Italy 2 years ago. For a semester in college. So traveling is something I've always wanted to do, something I've always been passionate about. Fortunately, I didn't end up going. In the future, man, I want to travel to as many places as I can. I want to go everywhere, man, all around the world if I can. So I hope you guys do too, man. Traveling is very important. It opens your mind a lot. It's good to be open and experience other cultures. This is like one of the second to last questions I'm gonna answer. Actually, a few more. I saw a couple good questions. My favorite food? I don't really have like a favorite food. I like soul food, man. I like Chinese food. I like Spanish, like Cuban food. I used to be kind of stingy with like the things I ate. Like I used to be pretty boring, but as of late, I've been trying to branch out with the type of foods I eat, man. So yeah, I really don't have a favorite kind of food. I love pizza, but I don't really have a favorite food, man. I like experiencing different foods from different cultures. So that's pretty much all the questions that I have to answer for y'all in this Q&A, man. Thank you for everybody that tuned in. Thank you for everybody that commented or, you know, wrote down a question and took out some time of their day so they could get to know me a little bit. Really been appreciating all the support, man. You guys have been awesome. And we're gonna keep grinding, man, I promise. If I didn't answer your question, it's probably because I answered it either in the previous Q&A. That link is in the description. You guys can go ahead and check that out. I either didn't answer it because it's on there or because I thought it was either inappropriate or just a question that I don't think I need to answer or something like that. That's basically why I didn't answer your question. One or the other, it's either A or B. Thank you guys again, man, for the support and for liking this video and subscribing to this channel. More content will be coming soon. That's a promise. Your boy is out. Look, I got $1 million skins and $1 billion flows, $1 million skins and $1 billion. I got $1 million skins and $1 billion flows. I put my heart in this world, cause that's just all that I know. Look.